क्वेश्चन नंबर 44B, पेज नंबर 1.14, ओमिशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल एंड सैलरी इन क्लोज अकाउंट्स। ए एंड बी आर पार्टनर्स इन अ फर्म शेयरिंग प्रॉफिट्स एंड लॉसेस इन द रेशियो ऑफ 3:2। द फॉलोइंग वॉज द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ द फर्म एज ऑन 31/3/2020। सो हियर द बैलेंस शीट इज गिवन। Capital A 60,000, B 20,000, total comes to 80,000, and on the asset side it is sundry assets 80,000. So here the capitals which are given in the balance sheet are the capital at the end. The profits rupees 30,000 for the year ended 31/3/2020 were divided between the partners without allowing interest on capital at the rate 12% per annum. Now, the profits have already been divided among the partners in the ratio 3:2, which is mentioned over there, above. And these profits were divided without allowing interest on capital at the rate 12% per annum. And salary to A at the rate rupees 1000 per month, means rupees 12,000 is the salary of A, 1000 per month, and for 12 months it is 12,000. And the interest on capital at the rate 12% per annum have not been provided for in the accounts of the partners. During the year, A withdrew rupees 10,000 and B rupees 20,000. And they have withdrawn this much amount. But no interest on drawings will be allowed on the will be charged, because it is not mentioned in the question, means it is not mentioned in the partnership deed, and we have to pass the adjustment entry to rectify this error. So first we will calculate the capital at the beginning to charge interest on capital. So for calculating the capital at the beginning, A and B, they are the partners. Capital as on 31/3/2020, A's capital was 60,000 and B's capital was 20,000. These are the figures given in the balance sheet. We will subtract the profit. The total profit was rupees 30,000 and it was divided between A and B in the ratio 3:2, that is A share is 18,000 and B share is 12,000. So after deducting it, it comes to 42,000. 60,000 minus 18,000 is equal to 42,000. 20,000 minus 12,000 is equal to 8,000. Now they have withdrawn rupees 10,000 and rupees 20,000 respectively. So A's drawing were 10,000 and B's drawing were 20,000. They will be added, and the total comes to 52,000. For A and 28,000 to for B. This is the capital as on 1/4/2019, that is the capital at the beginning. Now the wrong profit that has been distributed among the profits, wrong because neither the interest on capital to the partners and nor the salary to A were provided for. And we will take that wrong profit, 18,000 for A, 12,000 for B, total comes to 30,000. We will subtract the interest on capital at the rate 12% per annum, 6,240 for A and 3,360 for B. And this interest will be calculated on 52,000 and 28,000. Total interest comes to rupees 9,600. It will be subtracted from 18,000 minus 6,240. We will get 11,760. From 12,000 minus 3,360, we will get 8,640. Total 30,000 minus 9,600 will be subtracted. Total comes to 20,400. Now this 20,400, that was A salary was also not provided, so it will also be deducted. Less salary 12,000 for A and nothing for B, so 12,000 will also be deducted. So 11,760 minus 12,000 comes to negative 240, and here 8,640. From 20,400 minus 12,000, it comes to 8,400. This 8,400 is the profit that should have been divided among the partners. So it comes to 5,040, and the ratio will be 3:2. 5,040 is the share of A, and 3,360 is the share of B. Total comes to 8,400. This amount will be subtracted. So from minus 240, if we will subtract 5,040, minus minus will become plus, and the sign will remain of minus. So 5,280 negative is the difference in the capital account of A. And in case of B, from 8,640 minus 3,360, it again comes to 5,280, a positive figure. One positive is equal to one negative, and the resultant is zero. So the positive will be debited, B's capital account debit 5,280, and C's capital account will be credited 5,280. Now question number 44C. In this question, page number is 1.114. Following is the balance sheet of A and B for the year ending 31st March 2020, who shared profits equally. Now see the balance sheet of the previous question and this question. Here, A's capital on the liability side, A's capital is given 1 lakh, B's capital is given 80,000. On the asset side, and profit and loss account is given 20,000. On the asset side, sundry assets are given 1,70,000, and A's drawings are given 30,000. It means A's drawings have not been included in his capital. Now, B's drawings during 2019-20, this is given outside the balance sheet. B's drawings are mentioned outside the balance sheet. It means that B's drawing has already been added to, subtracted from B's capital. So, 25,000, and profits were 50,000. Out of this total profits of 50,000, 20,000 is shown in the balance sheet, means 30,000 was divided among the partners in their profit sharing ratio, which is equally. While finalizing the accounts for 2019-20, interest on capital at the rate 5% per annum and interest on drawings at the rate 6% per annum were inadvertently ignored. Pass an adjustment entry. So, in this case, we will calculate the capital at the beginning. First of all, for the purpose of providing interest on capital. So A's capital at the end is given in the balance sheet was 1 lakh, and B's capital at the end was given 80,000. B's drawings are given outside the balance sheet, and A's drawings are given inside the balance sheet, means A's drawing have not been deducted from this capital, but B's drawings have been deducted from his capital mentioned in the balance sheet. So first of all, we will add the drawings. In case of A, as the drawings have not been deducted, they are shown separately on the asset side of the balance sheet, so it will not be added over here. We will put a dash. B's drawings are shown outside the balance sheet as an adjustment, so they will be added. So it comes to 1 lakh for A and 1,05,000 for B. Now the profit, total profit was 50,000. 20,000 is shown in the balance sheet as profit and loss account, which means 30,000 has been divided among the partners equally. So 15,000, 15,000 is the amount of profit which will be subtracted. So capital as on 1/4/2019, that is at the beginning, comes to 85,000 for A and 90,000 for बी. नाउ द प्रॉफिट हैज बीन रॉन्गली डिवाइडेड अमंग द पार्टनर्स बिकॉज नाइदर द इंटरेस्ट ऑन कैपिटल वॉज प्रोवाइडेड एंड नॉर द इंटरेस्ट ऑन ड्रॉइंग्स वॉज चार्ज ऑन द ड्रॉइंग्स ऑफ द पार्टनर्स. सो वी विल टेक द रॉन्ग थिंग दैट विल दैट हैपेंड एट द बिगिनिंग. प्रॉफिट विच वॉज डिवाइडेड इक्वली 15,000 इज इक्वल टू 30,000. We will subtract the interest on capital at the rate 5% per annum. 5% of 85,000 is equal to 4,250 and 5% of 90,000 is equal to 4,500. Total comes to 8,750. This will be subtracted from 15,000 minus 4,250. It comes to 10,750. From 15,000 minus 4,500, it comes to 10,500. And from 30,000 minus 8,750, it comes to 21,250. We will add the interest on drawings at the rate 6% per annum. Now, the amount of drawings that is given, for A it is 30,000 and for B it is 25,000. Dates are not mentioned, means these were the lump sum amount that was withdrawn during the accounting period 2019-20. So 6 months interest will be calculated. See the working note. For A, 30,000 is the amount withdrawn, 6% is the rate of interest on drawings, and for 6 months, 6 by 12, it comes to rupees 900. For B, 25,000 is the amount withdrawn, 6% is the rate of interest, 6 by 100. For 6 months, it comes to rupees 750. So 900, 750. Total comes to 1,650. We will add this amount of interest on drawings because interest on drawings is an income of the partnership, because the partners will pay it to the firm. So 900 will be added and 750 will be added. After adding this, 10,750 mein 900 add kiya to 11,650. 10,500 we will add 750, we will get 11,250. And 21,250 mein 1,650 will be added, so 22,900. Now this is the actual profit that should have been divided among the partners, and we will divide it and deduct it. So, and the profit sharing ratio is equal. So 11,450 is for A, 11,450 is for B. Total comes to 22,900, and all will be subtracted. So here, from 11,650 minus 11,450, it comes to rupees 200 positive. From 11,250 minus 11,450, it comes to rupees 200 negative. And one positive is equal to the other negative, and the resultant is zero. So the positive will be debited, A's capital account debit 200, and the negative will be credited, B's capital account will be credited by rupees 200.